Hello. Always start with 10 inches by 10 inches. 600 X resolution, 600 Y resolution, pixels per inch. I do that because it's just, I like having a higher pixels per inch in case I print it out. But it does take up more space sometimes, I think. It gives you a warning, I always ignore it. I have 64 gigabytes of RAM, so it doesn't crash because it creates such a large image. So I just ignore it. I delete the background layer. I don't use background layers because I just don't. So first thing I can do to start out is just get a transition, something interesting, like abstract one, for example. Doesn't matter what it is. Set it to radial in shape, and just put it somewhere and try to get just a regular. I don't really care what pattern it is now. Whatever suits your fancy. Then I click on the move tool, and that finalizes the transition tool. There's another way to do it, but I don't remember. I've been doing that one so long. So, question is, now what do you do? Duplicate this layer. I don't really have a plan, I just go forward. Apply some techniques. So I'm going to use the move pixels, which will create movement and some variety there. I think I have it set so that it has some type of interpolation. Normally it doesn't do that. Normally it's smooth. But I have a setting, I don't know what setting I turned on. Sometimes you turn on a setting and you have no idea what you turned on, so that you can't turn it back till you figure it out. Okay, that's good enough for me, so go back to the move tool, and it'll apply the warp transformation. It's just to move it around, it's just to add some randomness a little bit. So it's not just like a perfect circle, which I tend not to do those. Okay, so I just made the opacity 50% or so. Doesn't have to be exact. Now, hue saturation. It's transparent, so it's showing through the bottom layer. But I'm going to change the hue. So basically that hue, I'll change it till it is kind of like complementary. So we'll say I like that. That's fine. See, if you were to see it without the transparency, you'd see this. The transparency lets the bottom layer show through. So merge these two. Now, I once heard that you shouldn't make an image blurry because making it blurry will destroy anything you're doing, and it's not value added, it's value subtracted. As far as I heard that once in a video, and I was always wondering if there's a way to undo that, make that not true, because I don't think you, who says it's value added? I mean, what if you like Blurry? Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and make it blurry by scaling the layer. I'm gonna shrink it down to 60 by 60 pixels and scale. This little tiny dot in the middle, it's shrunk way down. Scale layer. And then I'm gonna make it 6,000 again, back to where it was. And I'm gonna do pixels instead of inches. 6,000. Okay. It would have been a pain if I hit okay to, you know, 6,000 inches. That would have taken a long time. See, now it's blurry. Now why on earth would I make it blurry? Well, I'll show you in a bit. So I'm gonna go to swirl clockwise. Let's swirl it around a bit. Of course, it's not swirling because I have that weird setting on, or it's too large, or it's glitching. I don't know which one. I don't really care. So I'm gonna apply that. The larger your image is, the longer it's going to take for the warp transformation to apply. So, I made it blurry, then I swirled it, now I'm going to make it blurry again. So, pixels 60 by 60 again, scale. Layer, transform, scale layer, 6,000 by 6,000. So, and it's blurry again. I'm going to take the opacity to 50%, go to saturation, choose something that looks nice, good enough for me. I don't care about the colors right now, I tend to do that later. Merge those two together, duplicate, and save as always. I like to choose just random numbers like to save it as, because I'm not going to name it at this point. Now, filters. So what am I going to do with this? I'm going to choose colors in this contrast. So all those fuzzy shapes are going to turn into lines. So in order to do that, I'm going to turn up the contrast. And that's too much white, so I'm going to turn down the brightness. I just want a little bit like that, like a variety of colors there. And this, it's still blurry, so I'm going to go and repeat brightness contrast one more time. And I can do it one more time for good luck. Okay. That's about as good as it's going to get as far as contrast goes. And duplicate layer, transform, rotate 90 degrees clockwise. Take the opacity down to 50% again. Colors, hue, saturation, do something complementary. Okay, that looks fine to me. Now merge these visible layers. Edge detect. Now I'm going to create the lines. So everywhere there's a color that's different than another color to a certain degree, it's going to create a line with edge. And it's going to color in that line. I don't know how, like maybe opposite or something, I don't know. I'm going to turn the amount all the way up to get a thicker line. But these lines are not thick enough, and I don't want all this stuff going on that's on there now. So I'm going to select by color all the black. And the threshold should be right about there. When you select color, there's a threshold. A low threshold will only select a span of that color that is not as wide as another span that is greater if you turn the threshold up. Something like that. So I'm going to delete the black. Select none. Colors. Colorize just turns everything to that color. So I'm selecting this layer here. So I'm going to go to black. Okay. Okay. Going to add a new layer underneath this layer and fill it in white. And you can see those little thin lines. You can barely see them. Merge visible layers. Color invert. Just trial and error. I figured this out. Edge detect. No, sorry. Generic dilate. That just made the line thicker. It only works when you have a white line and a black background. So repeat dilate. It's just going to keep making those lines thicker and thicker. Repeat. 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 Now I'm going to go colors invert again. Get back to where I was. Now they're much thicker than they were. Select by color. The white portion. Delete that. Select none. Filters. No, sorry, colors. Colorize. I colorize it again because it's probably selected some white. The threshold select is not perfect. So you have to colorize after you do that to make sure there's no white lines next to black lines. So then go here and there's that. The lines aren't really that. Okay, I don't like those lines. Yeah, they kind of look like squiggly cartoon or something. And there's little edges, I don't like that. So what I'm going to do, unselect that. Duplicate layer. Layer, transform. Scale layer. Pixels, 60. Let's go lower, 50. 50, scale, layer, scale layer, 6000, not inches, pixels, scale, okay, it's nice and blurry again, so colors, brightness, contrast, we should turn it all the way up. Try to get a smoother line. It takes longer to turn it all the way up, but you get a smoother line. You just hit OK. I mean, if you turn the brightness up and down when the contrast is all the way up, it's just going to choose different paths, or I don't know what you call it, different. It's going to show up differently as a mix of colors. And so you just have to play with it until the desired effect has occurred. I'm just okay. Right now it looks like a scrambled egg. It's interesting. Or a fried egg, I'm sorry. Okay, so let's do that one more time. Brightness, contrast. Just turn that up, okay. Now you have these nice defined, I should say, lines. So these are the old lines. Let's get some new lines. Filter, edge type edge, mount all the way up. Okay. Select by color, select the black, delete, select none, colors, colorize, change it to black, okay, and I'm going to put a white underneath the lines. Merge visible layers, colors, invert, filters, edge, no, generic, dilate, and repeat. And repeat. See how they're smoother this time? Black, hit okay. Now you have that. Duplicate layer, transform, rotate 90 degrees clockwise. That just turns it that way. 90 degrees clockwise, make transparent and colors. Can't choose something that's not like too gray or something. There we go. Or looks like brightness. Okay, merge visible layers. Duplicate layer. I'd like to keep a duplicate layer in case I mess up. And then you can always do Control Z, but it comes in handy sometimes. Now I'm going to do filters, colors, I'm going to do exposure, turn the black all the way up, creates a richer color, do that multiple times, exposure, see how rich? Black level all the way up. Color exposure. Now I'm going to turn all the way up. And I'm going to do a teensy bit of exposure. Just a little bit of in colors. Exposure. Black level all the way up. Now I'm going to go to colors levels. This back level makes black really black. This middle one makes the colors in the middle really dark. I don't want that. Maybe a little bit here. You just gotta like, play with this levels tool until it does what you want it to do. And it takes a while to learn it. I mean, not a while, but a little while. Okay, colors, hue saturation. I'm gonna make the reds a little bit. We'll see. There we go. Yellows, lightness, saturation. There we go. Not a little less. Okay. And we're done. Got nice colors, some lines that conform to some of the shapes, but not all the shapes. It looks like something, kind of, abstractly, and I like it. It makes me feel okay. And that's it.